Joining me now is Mike Coyle. He's with Coquitlam Search and Rescue. Now, before you even leave the house, there are things you need to be doing to prepare if you're heading out for a hike this time of year.
Yeah, winter hiking is just like summer hiking with so many more restrictions, with shorter days, colder temperatures, and travel on snow making things slower. It cuts into your margin of safety, and you really have to be on the ball and ready for the weather and ready for what's going to happen. You have to take more clothing with you. You have to take more food. You have to take a bigger pack. You have to be faster and healthier to handle the winter conditions. And you have to take additionally more safety equipment.
Right, and you've brought here equipment that you normally wouldn't take if you're hiking in the summer, but these are things that are very necessary if you're going out this time of the year.
Yeah, the basics for winter travel outside of a controlled area in BC and anywhere in North America is a probe.
Okay, so this would...
Avalanche probe, an avalanche beacon, and a shovel. And these two items are used to rescue your friends in case of an avalanche.
Right.
And all three items are used for those things. And this is also used for a little bit of snow science to figure out what's going on in the snowpack underneath your feet as you're moving around.
So you have to have a bit of training as well to know what you're doing. Anyone couldn't just pick this up and know how to use this tool.
And that's the fourth item I can't put on the desk is the training. You need the training to know how to use this stuff. Otherwise, you're out there without a paddle.
And this time of year, the weather can be very unpredictable. It could look like a sunny day. And things can change. What are you supposed to do right away if that change does happen in the weather and you're out there already?
Well, hopefully you're prepared and you've got all these modern things like a GPS. But you know, if you find yourself in a survival situation, the best thing to do is to hunker down and find shelter and wait it out. Try not to move around too much. People feel that moving is going to give them some warmth and feeling that they're doing something, but you can exhaust yourself. And once that level of energy is gone, you got nothing left. And if you don't have shelter, you could succumb rapidly to hypothermia.
Very frequently this time of year, we hear these stories about people getting lost out there on hikes. What are some of the biggest mistakes that people make that can put them in real danger?
Well, the number one is overextending their ability, going beyond their own abilities, and that's easy to do. Those easy hikes in the summer, it's a beautiful day, you can see the trail markers. In the winter, none of that's there. You can't see the trail markers. It might be under 14 feet of snow, and the smallest thing is going to put you in a survival situation because of the cold weather.
Great. Thanks for being here.
Thank you very much for having me.